Good morning, children. I'm going to explain you English, Unit 10, Chapter, Who Will Be Ningdo. First of all, open your textbook, page number 167. Who will be Ningdo? This is a story from Manipur. In Manipuri language, the king is called as Ningdo, and the queen is called as Lima. This is a story about what qualities make a good ruler. Ruler means king. This story tells us about qualities which a good ruler must possess. It is important for every ruler to possess certain qualities so that they will keep their kingdom happy. So let's begin our chapter. Long, long ago, in the land of Kanglai Park in Manipur, there lived a Ningdo and a Lima. They were loved dearly by the people. Many years ago, there was a kingdom, Kanglai Park in Manipur, where Ningdo and Lima ruled. They were good rulers who worked for the best of their people. In return, the people of the kingdom also love and respect them equally. The Ningdo and Lima, on their part, never stopped thinking about their Miam. Miam means people, their people. Our Miam should be happy, they said. The Ningdo and Lima always thought about their Miam. They said, in their kingdom, their Miam should be happy. The people were not the only ones who loved their Ningdo and Lima. The birds and animals too loved them. The Ningdo and Lima always said, everybody in Kanglai Park should live in peace. Not only the people, but the birds, animals and trees. The Ningdo and Lima always thought about their Mia. The Ningdo and Lima not only loved by their people, but also loved by the birds and animals. They always said, everybody in their kingdom should live in peace. There should be no quarrel or fight. All creatures, including the birds, animals and trees, also should live in peace. Their beloved king and queen had three sons, Sanajoba, Sanayama, and Sana Thomba. 12 years later, a daughter was born. She was named Sana Thombi. She was a lovely child, soft and beautiful inside. She was loved by one and all. The king and queen had three sons, Sanajoba, Sanayama, and Sana Thomba. After 12 years, they had a daughter named Sana Thombi. She was lovely, soft and beautiful child. Everybody loved her. The years went by and the children grew up well. And then one day the Ningdo called all his ministers and said, it is now time to decide the Tungi Ningdo. Tungi Ningdo means the future king. After some years, their children, all the three children, grew up. So one day the Ningdo called all his ministers in his court to discuss about the future king. The ministers were shocked. But O Ningdo, what is there to decide? Sanajoba, your eldest son, will be your future king. Then the ministers were shocked and replied, O Ningdo, decision is very clear. Your eldest son, Sanajoba, will proceed the seat or will become the future king. Well, the Ningdo replied, that's how it happened in the old days. The eldest son always became the king, but times have changed. So let us select a king who is most worthy of becoming a king. Then the Ningdo said, "Yes, it is true. But it was happened in old days that eldest son always became the king. But the time or the situation has changed. We have to select a good ruler. We will have a contest to select the future king," the Lima said. And so in the land of Kanglaipak there was a contest, a horse race. Whoever reached the Khongnang means the banyan tree, first would be declared Tungi Ningdo. Then the queen Lima said that we would have a contest to select the future king. So it was decided, a horse race competition was held in their kingdom Kanglaipak among their children. Competition was a race competition, who will reach the Khongnang means banyan tree first, declared our future king. But then a strange thing happened. Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanathamba, all three of them finished the race together. They were expert riders and all three reached the finish line at the same time. Now the competition was started in Kanglaipak. But there was a coincidence. All the three sons were expert riders. Together they finished the race at the same time. There was great excitement. Look at them, the people shouted, "Shagol Thoba Nupa," such fine horsemen. Shagol Thoba Nupa means such fine horsemen. People were excited and shouted, "Such a fine horseman." But one question remained, who would be the Tungi Ningdo? But question was still remained there about the future king. The Ningdo and Lima turned to their sons. The Ningdo said, "Sanajoba, Sanayama and Sanathamba, you have proved that you are fine horsemen. Do something different, each one of you, so that we can decide who will be Tungi Ningdo." The Ningdo and Lima appreciated and congrats their children. "No doubt, you are a fine horseman, but each one had to prove in a different way so that we could decide about the future king." Suddenly, Sanajoba mounted his horse and held his spear straight in front of him. He looked around. There was a hush among people. "What is Sanajoba, the eldest, going to do?" they thought to themselves. Suddenly Sanajoba mounted. Mounted means ride. All the children were ready. First Sanajoba riding his horse and took spear. Spear means a long pole with a sharp point. Then he looked here and there. There was a hush. Hush means to stop talking. Quiet. So everybody was quiet and silent and thought what Sanajoba will going to perform. Sanajoba then looked at the huge Khongnang standing majestically in the distance. He pierced the tree and jumped his horse right through it. Pierced meaning make a hole. Then Sanajoba looked the huge Khongnang tree and threw the spear on the tree and made a big hole. Then he jumped his horse from right side. "Bravo, bravo," the people shouted. "Toro, toro," and then they fell silent. People shouted, "Bravo, bravo." Bravo, bravo means very bravely. Understood? The people shouted, "Toro, toro." Now it was turn to of the second son, Sanayama. What would he do? Sanayama too looked at the Khongnag as he mounted his horse. Then he too rode towards the tree harder and harder. The people watched in silence, afraid even to breath. When he was really close, he urged his force, urged meaning forced, to jump higher and higher. The horse rose until horse and rider jumped clear over the huge tree and landed on the other side in a wonderful motion. Then second son Sanayama came and he also did the same. He rode his horse towards the tree and forced his horse to jump higher and higher. Sanayama jumped over the huge Khongnag tree and landed on other side. The people breathed in relief and said in unison. Unison means together or simultaneously. Fuzzy, fuzzy means wonderful, wonderful. The people were shouted, wonderful, wonderful. And now it was the turn of the youngest son, Sanatamba. He too rode his horse towards the Khongnag and before anybody knew what was happening, uprooted it. Uprooted means to pull up a plant. Understood? Triumphantly he carried the tree to the Ningdo and Lima and laid it at their feet. Now the third son, Sanatamba, turn came and he also did the same and reached towards the Khongnag and this time he uprooted the tree. Sanatamba carried the Khongnag tree near the Ningdo and Lima at their feet. Shouts of Thoro, Thoro, Fuzzy, Fuzzy filled the mountains. The people shouted Thoro, Thoro means bravo, bravo. Fuzzy, Fuzzy means wonderful, wonderful. The people grew restless. Restless means nervous. Why were the Ningdo and the Lima taking so long to make the announcement? People were nervous or unable to relax. Why their king taking so much time for the announcement? They craned their necks to see what was happening. Craned means stretch. People stretched their necks to see what was happened around. The Ningdo and Lima were watching Sanatamba, their 5 years old daughter. She looked sad and lonely. She stared at the Khongnag, which lay dead by the throne. Birds flapped worriedly. Worriedly means concerned. Around, searching for their homes in the tree. Sanatamba walked up to the Khongnag and whispered. Whispered means speak very low. The Khongnag is dead. It was hurt by the spear and now it is dead. The Ningdo and Lima were watching Sanatamba. She was sad and looked at the Khongnag tree for a long time, which was dead. Birds, mentally troubled, and fly here and there to search their homes. Sanatamba spoke in very low that Khongnag tree is dead. It was hurt. The people were all attention. The Ningdo stood up. He looked at the three boys. He looked at the little girl. He turned to the people. If anybody is worthy of becoming the ruler, he said, it is little Sanatamba. It was she who told us to look at the soul of the Khongnag. Sanatamba feels the pain of others. She feels the pain of the people, the animals, the birds and the trees. The Ningdo looked at their sons and her little girl. Then he turned and said to the people, if anybody is able to become the ruler of Kinglai Park, she is Sanatamba, who feels or the pains of others. She felt the pain of people, animals, birds and trees. I declare Sanatamba the future Lima of Kinglai Peak. Kinglai Peak. The Ningdo said, a silence fell. Everyone turned to look at the little girl, their future queen. There she stood, all of five, like a small conch, with birds flying all around her. They sat on her shoulders and on her head. She held out her hands full of grain, and the birds flapped about her, pecking at the foot. Pecking means eating. Then Ningdo declared, Sanatomi will be the future Lima of Kinglai Peak. Everybody was silent. Then everybody turned towards the little girl who will be the future queen. She was stood like a conch tree, the birds flying around her, and some birds sat on her shoulders, some sat on her head. She held out her hands with full of grains, and the birds pecking the food. A Lima is one who doesn't hurt anybody in the kingdom. Then the Lima was the future king, queen, who doesn't hurt anybody in the kingdom. I hope you understand the lesson.